If you like instant automation, there's a good chance you're a huge fan of webhook triggers. The webhook can be most easily activated with the push of a button from inside of Airtable, and it's gonna trigger your automation to instantly activate and do whatever magic you have set up for it on the back end. But the frustrating part about this is it always opens up that webhook URL in another window, and then you've gotta just close out that window and it's just an extra step. So wouldn't it be cool if there was a way for you to do all of that, the instantaneous automation webhook trigger, without the extra window pop-up? Well, if you want to learn how, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about all of the stuff that we do to help, check out the links below. We'll have them pasted all around this video. And don't miss my upcoming live webinar training. This is a training that I do once a week, 100% live, and we hop on and talk about how you can leverage automation to empower your business so that you can save more time. I personally save 20 hours per week of my own time, and I help my clients do the same. So if that's of interest, check out the free webinar link below. Sign up at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And even if you can't attend live, I will send you the replay of that training. So check it out, link below. But without further ado, let's get into how we're gonna build this awesome webhook trigger without actually pushing a button. So first things first, let's hop on into my Airtable and explain the setup. So we could easily create a button field here, and as I mentioned, we could assign a webhook to it. We could append the record ID of each record to that button so that when we push the button, it triggers the webhook with that specific record ID and information involved. But as we said, we don't want that extra window popping up, so how can we avoid it? So let's imagine instead of pushing a button, we have some very specific things that we're looking for in order to trigger this automation. For example, in my case, I'm saying, hey, this status field needs to be updated to third. So status, first and foremost, I've got four different status: first, second, third, fourth. Whatever these are, in my case, third is gonna be the magic status that triggers the automation. So when I change one of these status to third, I want that to act as the button. But of course, it's not gonna open a new URL. What it is gonna do though is pop into a specific view. So we need to build a specific view that filters in only those records that we want to trigger the automation. This is very similar to if you built a standard automation that watches a specific view. But as you probably know, if you build a standard watch view automation trigger, it can take 5 to 15 minutes before the automation triggers, and we don't want to wait that long. So instead, we're going to tighten up that time frame using our webhook trigger. But we still need this view in order to get things going. So we set up a filter for this view where the status is third. All right, so only when a record enters this view will the next thing happen. And that next thing is actually an automation built inside of Airtable. Now, Airtable automations activate very quickly. Not quite as fast as a webhook trigger, but pretty darn fast, usually within 5 seconds of the conditions being met. So inside of Airtable automations, we are building an automation that says when a record enters this view, specifically that status view equals third. So only when a record pops into this status equals third view will this trigger the automation. Great, now we run a script. Now, full transparency, I am not a script writer, as I've said many times on this channel. This is a script that I found inside of the Airtable community forums, a great resource if you're not already using it. So thank you to the people who comment there and provided this amazing script. So what we're doing now inside of our Airtable automation, after the record enters the view of status equals third, then we want this script to operate. And so what we need to do inside of here is first and foremost, get into the code. We need to make sure that we add an input variable. We need to bring in the record ID of the record that triggered this automation. In order to do that, simply say add input variable, give it a name, and assign the value. In my case, I'm calling it record ID, and I'm assigning the value, of course, of the record ID. Now, if you can't find the record ID, what you need to first do, let's pop back into our database, is make sure to give it a record ID. Now, if you're not familiar, a record ID is automatically assigned to every record in Airtable when it comes into existence. We don't normally see this ID, but you can access it by writing a formula, record underscore ID, open close parentheses. And that will bring up or display the record ID for every single record in that database table. All right, so back to our code then. We are simply writing these three simple lines here, let the URL equal, and then inside of here, we're going to bring in our webhook. So if you're using Zapier, or in my case, I'm building this in Integromat, I'm gonna bring in that webhook and I'll show you how we get that in just a moment. Then we need to append it with question mark record ID equals, right? And then we're closing out that quotation. And then here is where we are going to bring in that record ID. So again, let input config equal input.config. And then we're gonna fetch the record ID that we just passed from the trigger. Now, you don't have to know code. I certainly don't in order for this to work. Just follow step by step what I've outlined here and copy this code. I will be sure to paste it below in the comments of this video if you're watching on YouTube, so you can just grab it from the comments there. Now, what this code allows us to do is actually activate the webhook and append the webhook with the record ID. It's identical to if we had created a button with the webhook on it. The bonus here, of course, is that we don't have to open up that extra page. We don't have to actively click that button. As soon as the record enters that view, it's going to trigger the webhook based on this two-step automation. Now let's go into our automation tool and see what happens when we activate the webhook. So, as I said, in my case, I'm doing this in Integromat. This could be a two-step automation, but I've added a third step just to make it a little bit more clear. First and foremost, we have our webhook. Go ahead and create your own webhook and copy the webhook address to your clipboard. Remember, we're gonna have to go back now into our script and edit this little piece. This is unique to your specific webhook for your automation that you build in either Integromat or Zapier. So make sure to update this to reflect your webhook, because that webhook right here is unique in every single case. Once we've got that, onto the next step, we're going to get a record in Airtable. Now this is the extra step that we don't necessarily have to take in this example, because all I'm doing here is looking at the record or getting that record, searching for it in my Airtable database. You only need to perform this step if you need more information from the record. For example, let's flip back into the record. If you need to know what the checkbox is, either yes or no, if you need to know what the status is or what the name of the record is or a future part of your automation, then you need to look up the record so that you can find all that other information. In our case, we don't need to know that, which is why this isn't really a required step, but I wanted to outline it for you just so you knew what was required in a more complicated case. Now in the third step, now that we found the record, and by the way, we're finding it based on the record ID that was passed in the webhook, now that we've found it, we're gonna move into the final step of the automation, and in our case, all we're gonna do is check that box so that when all of this is complete, we're going to mark the checkbox to be yes or the record ID that activated the webhook in step one. So let's take a look at this whole thing in action now that it's set up. Make sure your automation is turned on here. Also make sure that your automation in Airtable is turned on and updated just in case you made any changes to the code. And once we're all set with this, we'll go back into our grid view, that is the view that has all of our records, and we'll make a change to this one and we'll update it to third. This, in turn, moves this record into our other view, which triggers our automation here to run the script. That then sends the information to the webhook, which then performs the automation of coming back and checking the box as you just saw there in real time. It happens pretty darn fast, not quite as fast as hitting a button, because we have this extra step of running the script inside of Airtable. But otherwise, this is a very fast way of activating an automation, and you get to skip the pain of having to open up a window that does nothing and then closing out the window that does nothing. It's just an extra step, and now you can totally bypass that step. And if you're using Integromat, as we've talked about in previous videos, it's highly recommended that you use webhooks to trigger your automations because it costs you a lot fewer operations. When you're watching records with Integromat, it has a tendency to chew through your operations and it's a longer wait time for you. So I strongly recommend that you use a webhook as a trigger, and this is a great way to make it a more seamless approach. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you did, be sure to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're not already, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.